proliferate by binary fission. The capacity of cells to duplicate themselves, utilizing the information encoded in the genome and raw materials from the environment, is nothing short of magic. This sophisticated process, called the cell cycle, is one of the most basic biological pathways. All cells ultimately originate from the first cell that gained this capacity endless cell generations ago. Even in our high-tech culture, humans have not yet invented a single gadget that can replicate itself in this manner. The cell cycle of eukaryotic cells consists of two main phases: the interphase, during which the cell replicates its content, and mitosis, during which it segregates this content and divides into two daughter cells. The cell contains a large variety of molecules and organelles that are all segregated to its daughters. The genome encoded by the chromosomes is replicated and segregated with very high fidelity.
When we learned about DNA in the previous chapter, we did not mention its most iconic property, that it is a double helix. As a double helix, the information on one strand complements the one on the second strand, and thus enables replication. Opposite to every A is a T, and opposite to every C is a G. One strand encodes the genetic information and the other complements it. When a cell replicates its chromosomes, the double helix unwinds and a new complementing strand is formed on every one of the original ones. At the end of the process, we have two identical double strands. Each of these strands forms one sister chromatid of the chromosome. The two sister chromatids of each chromosome are attached to each other by proteins. Throughout interphase, the chromosomes are not condensed and there's no way to see them. After replication and additional events, the cell gradually enters mitosis. The chromosomes condense and attain their well-known shape. The nuclear envelope breaks down, the mitotic spindle, a fiber network that binds the chromosomes and connects them to the poles of the cell, is formed. Ultimately, each one of the two chromatids is attached to fibers that pull it to one of the poles. The proteins that connect the two sisters prevent their separation at this stage. The pulling force towards the poles, which are opposed by the proteins that connect the sisters, leads to a stable equilibrium so that all chromosomes get positioned in the center of the cell. The cell is a special mechanism that ensures that mitosis will proceed only when all chromosomes are correctly attached to the spindle. As this happens, the proteins that hold the sisters together are cleaved and the sister chromatids separate and are pulled to the opposite poles of the cell. In the final stage of the cell cycle, the cell itself divides into two.